Hey everyone, welcome to the new session Data Analysis of Amazon Review. Before start the session, let me introduce myself. I'm Shampriti from Great Learning. And guys, please do let me know in the live chat I am audible or not. If I am audible, then please put a yes comment to the comment section. For that, we can start the session. And in the meantime, let me introduce that Great Learning has come up with a brilliant idea, that is Great Learning Academy, where you will get almost 80 plus free courses. And after complete your course, you can claim your certificate as well. And if you want to do these courses in your mobile application, that is also possible using Great Learning app, right? So give me a quick confirmation that I am audible or not. If I am audible, then we will start today's session. And I want this session to be more interactive, guys. So I will keep you asking the questions, and I will expect that you will also answer my questions, right? Yeah, so in this session, we will talk about data analysis. We will talk about how can you scrape data from Amazon, and then we will do some kind of a data analysis using those data. And then I will ask you a few questions as well. If you have any doubt, then please do let me know, right? And I will help you out with your solving your doubts as well, right? Okay, I can see you guys are saying you are audible. Okay, got it. Okay, so we can start with the session. So let's have a agenda that we are going to, what we are going to do. So as I can, before giving the agenda, can you guys give me a quick confirmation that how many of you have the idea about Python? So basically in this session, we will do the what is Python, a little bit of a few seconds of what is Python, the history of Python, talk about Python, then we will do scraping the data. So then we will talk about it scraping legal. From there, we will talk about what is Beautiful Soup. We have the, you know, the library we have. And then we will scrape the data from Amazon. And again, lastly, we will do the data analysis using those datas, right? So how many of you have the idea about Python? Give me a quick confirmation. So if you give me a quick confirmation that how many of you have the idea about Python, then maybe I will just talk a few minutes about Python, the features of Python, and then we will jump into the data scraping part. So just give me a quick idea that how many of you have idea about Python. Sarah is saying, yes ma'am, I have the idea of Python. Okay, I got two response. Rishit, yes, this session will be recorded, and after the live itself, you can see this after as a live recorded session. Okay, so okay, I can see some of you have idea about Python. Then we will go and move forward, right? Okay, so let's start with what is Python. So we know Python is a high-level object-oriented and interpreted language. So when we talk about high-level object-oriented and interpreted language, we talk a lot of time that high-level means we know normally if we need to talk about the, if we need to work with, Okay, I can see you guys have idea about Python. Who doesn't have idea about Python? That's also fine, because anyway, whatever I'm going to do, I will just explain everything. Okay, fine, Upakar, that's not the problem. Cool, right. So anyway, what we are going to do, we are going to do this Python part, right? We are going to do this Python part in a very quickly, and then we will jump into the web scraping part. So yeah, when we are talking about the high level part, so yes, for the Python, you can just directly jump into the, you know, the Python language itself. You don't need to go with the low level language to interact with the computer, right? So this is why Python is high level. This is object oriented and interpreted language. After that, we are going to talk about why should you learn Python. I will give this quick points that Python is simple. Whenever we are going to do the demo, you can see this Python is simple, right? And beginner friendly, obviously. If you don't know any language, Python is for you. I can say Python, the length of the program is really short. You just need to write a few lines of code and your work is done. Then comes the mathematical computations, can be done easily. So if you go for data science part, So in that case, yes, mathematical computations, you need to do a lot of time, and yes, that will be very easy with Python. And the web development, you can do plus graphical user interface, right? Cool. Now we are going to talk about why Python is so popular. Python is popular because of the largest community for learners and collaborators. It is open source and it's easy to learn. The main thing I can say, it supports big data, machine learning and cloud computing. So, and deep learning, we can talk about any new upcoming languages, big data, right? So all these things are supported by Python, and Python supports automations as well, right? This was all about Python. I hope you got the idea, like why Python popular, why we are doing all the, you know, almost all the part in Python, why not other languages? So this is the main results for you. No, we are not going to do the analysis by using Power BI. We are going to use Python itself, right? Okay, so now it's going to talk about installing Python. So we can go to their official website, that python.org. From that, directly you can actually install Python. So it's the part of installing Python. Then comes the ID, the integrated development environment. Most of you used to ask me that which one I should use. So there are lots of options we have, right? Saurav, no, we are not going to use natural neural networks because we are not going to make any model. So if you want to do the analysis of sentiment analysis, basically, that time maybe you can go for using neural networks. But this analysis, we are going to cover the EDA part, right? Okay. So yeah, if you want to install Python, go to their official website, and according to your system configuration, that your system is Mac or Windows, you can choose that in between them. Then comes Anaconda. Anaconda is basically, again, an installation site they have. This is known as a data science toolkit. So if you really start with data science with a good ID, I should suggest you Anaconda. There are lots of things you will get. And then we also have one more that is my favorite. Google Colaboratory. I mean, I love Google Colab. So how many of you know about Google Colab? I got few questions for analysis. R is better or Python? So Gurpreet, if you talk about the R and Python, again, we talk lots of time about this too. So Python is basically good for, you know, if you go for the basic analysis, but if you really need to do some mathematical, more of a stat analysis, for that you need to use R. That will be more preferable. Who's Newman? I'm not able to. Okay, you are not able to install Python, but that's something, some problem should be shown. If you can share that error with me. Is it necessary to use PyCharm? No, this is not necessary. If you want, you can use any of the IDE, or you can go for using Notepad as well. Newman Hussain, I think I gave your answer. Okay, so you guys have... Saurav is saying Google Colab is better than Jupyter. I mean, I myself love Google Colab a lot. It's very easy to use, very flexible to use, right? So this is the main thing. Yes. Right. So how many of you actually know that how this Google Colab features are? I mean, you don't know, there are lots of hidden features are there for Google Colab, and you really can start working with your code is needed a very high computations power, then also you can start working with Google Colab. That's the main thing I love about Google Colab. Right. Google Colab is not a web app. It's a IDE, integrated development environment, that is made by Google to help the researcher of artificial intelligence. Right. This is what. Yeah, Jupyter Notebook is also best. Some of for you. I mean, this is, I cannot compare them, but for my case, I love Google Colab. So if you don't know Google Colab, why don't you go and check it out? Our Google Colab tutorial. Our moderator is already sending the link. Right, now we are going to talk about web scraping, right? So what is web scraping? How many of you have idea about web scraping? I just want to I'm just curious, you know, I'm just wondering that how many of you actually I will see your answers, guys. But I just want to know, what is web scraping? What do you know about web scraping? Did you ever heard the term web scraping? I don't know, Google Colab. Okay, that's totally fine. Check it out our videos. Upakar is saying, ma'am, what is Google Colab and what can be done there? Google Colab is an idea, Upakar. Why don't you go and check out our video again? It will give you a proper idea that what is Google Colab, how Google Colab invented, and you know, what are the features you have for Google Colab. Akash, that's totally fine if you have PyCharm installed. Okay. Raghavendra, you are saying it's taking so much time to run. What is taking so much time to run? Brajesh, yes, right. For machine learning projects, Saket, you can use Jupyter Notebook as well as you can use Google Colab. Any one of your choice. Okay. Yes, some of you said yes, they do know about web scraping. Yes, Saket, it's a way to get or extract data from websites. Yes, you're right. Kumar Rohit, no, I cannot speak in Hindi in this session. We do have lots of sessions in Hindi because I'm really very bad in Hindi. I mean, if I start, I can talk, but I cannot teach in Hindi. COVID data presentation is one of type of web scraping. For data presentation, I don't think it's a web scraping. Basically, web scraping, it scrap the data from the website itself. Right, so let's have a look at what is web scraping. So web scraping stands for extraction of data. Okay, yes, it's extraction of data from a website. The information is collected, right? The information is collected from the websites. Right, so for now being, you can say, what is web scraping? Web scraping basically stands for the extraction of the data from a website. If you want to feed few data from the website, you can use web scraping technique. And the information you will collect from the website itself and then exported those data into a proper format. Like for today's data, what I did, I scraped the review from Amazon and I stored them in Excel. And then what I did, okay, I stored them in Excel, and from there I will do the data analysis, right? So this is way you can scrape the data from some websites, and then you can use those data to .csv format, you can Excel, you can store the data to Excel or any other format, right? Okay, and web scraping can be done manually as well. You can, if you want to do manually, you can do it, but normally prefer to use automated tool for web scraping, right? There are lots of automated tools are there to do the scraping, right? Okay, now we are going to talk about why web scraping is needed. So I think you got an idea that what is web scraping. Give me a quick confirmation and I will quickly jump into the demo, because I feel demo is more of an interesting part. Give me a quick confirmation that yes, what is web scraping? Okay, what is data mining? Data mining, we will talk about what is data mining. Okay, I just want a quick confirmation from you guys that you got it. What is web scraping? Okay, I got 3 reply. Yes. Okay, guys, the session to be more interactive, why don't you talk about what you know about web scraping and what your ideas of doing something using fetching the data from web, right? Yes. And if you really like the video, the live session, please do hit like and also subscribe Great Learning for upcoming new exciting videos. We are going to come up with so many new exciting conceptual and applications type of video as well. And please do check out our Great Learning Academy. There are lots of features where we have added, and you can use them to skill up yourself as well. Upakar is asking that what are the tools are used for web scraping. We will talk about that. first learn what is web scraping and why do we need web scraping, right? Extraction. Okay, extraction from website and display with desktop app. Didn't get you. It's used for extracting the data, you can say data acquisition part. Okay, right. Now we are going to talk about why web scraping is needed, right? Because the web scraping is needed because it helps to fetch email address gathering. Suppose I am giving you the list of reasons that why I think that this web scraping is needed. Suppose you want to fetch email addresses, right? If you want to make your own data sets, right? So that time if you know that, okay, there are lots of email addresses there in this particular website itself, but I don't know, I mean, how can I have those details? That time you can go for using web scraping, right? And you can use like if you want to see, there is a website where you can see according to the skill sets, there is a lots of lists of jobs are there. In that case also you can use web scraping, right? If you want to do price comparison, if you don't know, we have done one price comparison one, right? Price comparison using different e-commerce sites. That time you can use web scraping. If you didn't check, then please check that out, right? And in the case of research and development also web scraping is needed. Some of the cases for the research and development, you know this, there is lots of content, lots of data is there in the web. Okay, lots of like data in the web. That time if you want to face them, you can use web scraping. Aman, whose email address for email marketing itself? For the email marketing, they use emails to do your emails, right? Okay, Ananjana, Ananjana, okay, fine. That's really nice, good. Now we are going to talk about, is web scraping legal? It's the way we are fetching the data from website, is it legal? So that time, yes, web scraping is legal. You are allowed to scrape anything which is publicly available. If your data is publicly available, you are allowed to scrape those data, right? So this is the main thing I want to talk about. And you are allowed to scrape anything which is publicly available again. But if you are sending multiple requests in a very short span of time to Amazon, that your real IP address will be blanked. Trust me, it happened to me. I was just making the code, and that time I have sent so many like multiple requests to the Amazon, and that time I was not able to face the data. Guys, I'm really sorry for the background noise because some construction is going on. This is not my fan noise, so I'm really sorry for that. Right? Yes. Fine. So this is the reason that yes, web scraping is illegal if it's the data is publicly available. If the data is publicly available, you don't need to do anything. There are lots of libraries we have in Python like Beautiful Soup, Scrapy. You can directly scrape those data. But if it's not, then you will not able to phrase those data. So you will get an error for that, right? You will get a request response error that time, right? How many of you understand about what is web scraping, why do we need that, and is scraping legal? Then we are going to talk about a few parts, right? And we will talk about the library we are going to use, and we will jump into the project, right? We will jump into Beautiful Soup. So give me a quick confirmation that you understand what is web scraping, you understand why do we need that, and you also understand that is it legal. So anytime you are going to do web scraping, be careful whatever the data you are using that is publicly available. Okay, give me a quick confirmation guys, then we will talk about Beautiful Soup. That yes, you have understood. Then we will just jump into Beautiful Soup. Okay, right, yes. Once more about web scraping, whenever we are going to do the like demo, that time we are going to talk about that. Okay, so I got the confirmation you guys understand about web scraping. Now we are going to talk about what is Beautiful Soup. So Beautiful Soup is a part of Python library. Again, it's a Python library to get the data out of HTML, XML and other markup languages. Right. So it's like part of Python library, and if you want to get the data without that HTML tags, XML tags, and the other markup language, right? The Beautiful Soup will help you out with that. Well, I will show you how to do that. Okay. Now, if you want to fetch data from a particular website, but they don't provide downloading data. So I'm giving you the like scenarios when and why do we need it, right? So in that case, so suppose if you can say, okay, if I need to take the data, maybe I can copy paste it. That's not a good idea, but I'm still giving you idea that there is some data, particular data you want to fetch, right? That time, they don't provide downloading the data. How can you get the data? That time you need to go for using. Vikash is like giving me, like asking me some questions. Okay, I will answer your question, Vikash. Okay. So in that case, Beautiful Soup helps you to fetch the data or the particular content by removing the HTML tags, right? So this is what web scraping stands for. We already talked about is web scraping legal or not. Now we are going to do the analysis of Amazon review. First, we will scrape the data from Amazon and then we will jump into the data analysis part, okay? Okay. So you guys were asking about we did not get the data set, we did not get the IPYNB file. Now you will get everything, PDF and the data set we are using, the code file we are using, everything you will get in Great Learning Academy. Please go and check that out. And also, you like, if you do have any questions, do let me know in the comment sections. I will love to help you out, guys. And if you like the video, then please do like the video, for that we can understand you are liking the video as well. That will actually give us motivation to do such kind of videos as well. And do subscribe Great Learning for getting the notifications, right? Okay, now we are going to talk about Google Colab. So how many of you already, you guys say that you guys have idea about Google Colab? Do I need to show you how to start up with Google Colab? Then quickly I will show you that, and then we will jump into the code. Give me a quick confirmation that do I need to show that how you need to start with the Google Colab. Right. Raghavendra, yes, you can scrap data. That's not the problem if the data is publicly available and if the data is yes. Okay, okay, so let me just show you how to do that. Go to your favorite browser and just write Google Colab. This is so simple, guys. Right, go to Google Colab, click on over here, right? From there, click over here, new notebook. Right? Yes, yes, you can follow the session with Jupyter Notebook as well. Right? Okay, your notebook is ready. Now, if you want to change the name of your notebook, write demo. Right? So, this is how you can make a demo IPYNB file with Google Colab. If you want to upload, suppose we are giving you the data set, we are giving you the code file as well. If you want to upload that, right, how to do that? Okay, now if you go there, can you see this this part? If you are able to see this, yes, you will get this file. Everything you will get in the Great Learning Academy. So let me show you where you will get all these things, all the data set. So Great Learning Academy, if you go to Great Learning Academy, click over here, right? And from there, just to where to get the data set. So can you see this data analysis of Amazon reviews, right? Go there, register for this course, okay? Register for this course, you will get all the material, the presentation we are using, as well as the code file we are using, right? So you will get everything, and our moderator is also sending the link as well. So you can just go and click on that link and you will get all the material we are using so far, for this particular session. Right, I hope it gives you the answer. And this is how this demo file for Google Colab working. Can you see this part? Can you see this sign over here? Click over this sign, you will get this window open. Then click over this sign, right? If you have the IPYNB file, and from IPYNB file, if you want to upload that particular file, click over here and use your this part, right? Amazon review file, the code file I have used over here. Right, so if you already downloaded this from the Great Learning Academy, you can directly upload that as well. So this is how this Google Colab works. This is a very short introduction to Google Colab, but yes, this is something, if you really want to know more, go and check out the video. Right, so now what we are going to do, we are going to use import requests. Lakshmi, in this session we are going to not going to do the machine learning project. Right, so can you see, we are going to import request library. This is basically, this library help you to give the request for HTTP requests, right? So this is the library we have in Python. Now we are going to use Beautiful Soup from BS4 import Beautiful Soup. We are going to use this first two library. Okay, from there I have given this link. Why this link? If you go this link, right, can you see, we are going to scrape the data for this customer reviews, right? This Nautica analog silver dials means watch, right? So we are going to scrape data for this particular product. If you want to scrape any product's review, you can do that, right? Okay. Okay, now what we are going to do, now we are going to do this URL. So this URL is basically is a variable, right? This is a variable where you give this link, right? Just copy this, control C, and paste over here, right? You are doing this link, right? This is your URL, right? After that, what you need to do, you need to have headers. If you ask me what is headers, header is basically HTTP header user agent is used to request header that allows a characteristic strings and allows network protocol peers to identify the operating system. So whenever you are going to use this web scraping and whatever the technology where you are scraping the data, that time what you need to do, you need to identify the scraping techniques, try to identify your IP address, your operating systems, right, and the browser of the web server, right? And your browser sends the user agent to every websites you connect to. There is a no conventional way of writing a user agent string, as different browser use different formats and many web browser load a lot of information onto their user agents, right? When the browser is connected to a website, a user agent field is included in the HTTP header. I will show you how you will get your user agent for your particular system, right? The data of the header field varies from browser to browser. So whatever the browser you are using, it varies over there. The this information used to serve the different website to different web browser and the different operating systems. So basically you will get three parts over here. One is operating system. What is your operating system? What is your browser, right? And what is your the server as well, your IP address, everything will be fetched using user agent data, right? So that's why I said always you are using any technique, try to use go for using publicly available data. That's not the problem to use them, right? Now if you want to check that what is your browser user agent, right, go to the web browser and write my user agent, right? Can you see I got my user agent, that Mozilla 5.0 Windows NT, Windows 64, Apple WebKit 537.36, Chrome 85.04183, right, Safari. So this is all my user agent, right? Can you see, this is my user agent. Okay, so this is how we are going to use the user agent. So if you have any doubt, that's why I am just repeating it for lots of time, because whenever I go for doing any session on web scraping, the most of the time I get the question that how to get my user agent. So this is how you can get my user agent, and this is why we are using this user agent wala part, right? So yes, the headers will be this, right? Your headers will be this with a curly bracket. Now you are going to make the request to get the URL. Okay, that time you need to pass two parameter. One parameter is URL, you want to fetch the data, and the headers I have shown you, headers will be your user agent, right? It's this user agent, the headers actually basically takes a dictionary. Can you see it's a dictionary? It's a like curly bracket, then user agent is the key and the value is this, your user agent, right? How many of you understand this user agent part? Give me a quick confirmation, because I want this basics part to be very clear. Guys, give me a quick confirmation and I want the response from you, then we will jump into the next part. Yes, give me a quick confirmation on this. I'm just waiting for your response, guys. Hashmukh is saying, please repeat. How many of you want a repeat from my side for user agent? I think clean is properly clear. Amani is saying, understood. Guys, you are almost 75 people are here. I am not getting the proper interaction from you guys, because if you really understand the live sessions, I want you to be more interactive. I mean, this something helps me to understand you guys are understanding or not. Please repeat one more request. Okay, one more. How to get the link of Amazon? The link of Amazon, any product you want to fetch, guys. I mean, for my case, I just take the men's watch. You can go for using anything. Okay. Yes, mama, it's necessary to do user agent. I mean, okay, user agent. First, try to understand. Yes, in Amazon review link, Bajresh. Go and check this out, right? If you go this Nautica analog silver dial men, if you go to this product, go down. I don't need to show you how you'll get the customer review, right? Go there and check this out. This one. Okay. So this is something maybe here, right? We are going to take this. Okay. So you can use this as well. Why is the link? Oh my God. Why am I not getting the link? Okay, so for top reviews I was getting the link over here. Maybe here you can go. Okay, some of you are asking what's the point of doing this. Okay, so in this case I can. Okay, so this is the way. This is the way you will get the link. Right, I get. Just show another website. Yes, you can do it with Flipkart as well. Okay, what's the point of extracting reviews this way when we are check them right on the website? So, it's something, it's not like something you are going to buy and you are just checking it out. It's something that data analysis you want to do for a particular product. That time you have to have this. That time you have to have this data, right? Okay, so this is how you will get the review, right? Oh, thank you. Someone said click on the 5-star. Yes, I got it. Thank you so much. I was not able to find it out that. Okay, right. Yes, this is how you will get the emotions one, right? Okay, now that this is how I want the engagement, guys. Right, okay, now what we are going to do, I have talked about the user agent. Again, I'm just repeating with a few seconds that user agent is basically used to take your browser, your operating systems, your IP address. It will take all of data and then it will redirect you to the link you want to go for, right? So this is how the user agent part works. Now we are going to make the request that page, okay? So it's basically making the request to check is your page is can you just use this page or not. So in this case, if you get the response 200 greater than, so basically when you get this 200 greater than, that time you can say, okay, you got the request, you have the access that, okay, you can check, like you can scrape the data from this particular page, right? If the page is private, you will get a response. This 200, why they use, I really don't know. you will get a response that yeah, this is a private page, right? Now what you need to do, you need to use the Beautiful Soup. So Beautiful Soup is our what? Is our the library. And Beautiful Soup, it's something like you are going to check, okay, you are calling the library as well. Okay, so Beautiful Soup, you are calling the function Beautiful Soup, then page.content. You want all the content from the page, and then HTML parser. You don't want the HTML part. Okay, you just want the content only, not the HTML part. Right? Now what you need to do? You can print the title of the page. You can print the title.name of the page, the attributes. Then title.string, title.printname, you can use all these things. Can you see you got this Amazon.in customer reviews, Nauticas, analog, silver main watch. Can you see this is a title. Then you get the dials, men's watch. This is the meta, right? These all the things you got, right? The title of the page, that you know, what is the page is all about, everything you got. It's a customer review page we have given. Okay. Right. Now what we are going to do, you are going to say, hey, I want to go and check this particular profile name, and I want to, yes, I'm sure, Hashmukh, they use 200 for success response code, yes, that's the thing, yeah. So now what we are going to do, I'm really sorry guys for the background noise, there is a constructions going on, that is how it's too much of background noise, okay. Now you can see this soup.find. If you can ask me what, from where do you get this span and class and profile name, if you go here, right, go here, control shift C for doing the inspecting page. And if you want to inspect page, you can go here, right click, can you see inspect option, right click on the inspect option, your space, like you will get all the HTML tags over here. So this is why we use this, right? Okay, this is why we use the inspection of the page. It will help you to get the all the HTML part of the page, right? So now if you go to, can you see the customer's name, right? There is a span you have called the profile a.profileName. If you just double click over here, you will get this span. Can you see this class you are getting, that a profile name? Copy this part, right? A profile name. Okay, control C. Now if you come back here, write soup.find. What is the type of this? This is a span. Then this is the class, right? Then this is the class, and then you have this profile name, the a profile name wall part, right? And from there you said, hey, I want the title. Title dot get text. Text is basically, it will not fetch any HTML value, it will only fetch the text from there. Can you see? We got it. The customer name we got. This is how we can fetch the data, right? We can fetch the data from an Amazon review page. The customer review page, right? Okay. So I hope you understand how this review part works. Let me just give me a quick confirmation on that, for that we can jump the next part. Now we are going to do the data analysis. The same way I have made my data set, right? You can use the same way to do your making your data set, and from there you can do the data analysis part, right? Give me a quick confirmation, guys. I'm just waiting for your confirmation. Now it's something we are going to talk about, the data analysis part, right? Yes, now we are going to talk about the data analysis part, how to do that. First we are going to talk about the NumPy part, why do we use NumPy. Then we are going to talk about the pandas. Guys, give me a quick confirmation, I'm just waiting for your confirmation. It's just I want this session to be more interactive. Every time I say that, Shudhangshu is saying yes. Okay, do you have any doubt to clear? Then we can clear the doubt and then we can start working, I mean for the next part. Abhishek Agarwal is saying no. Okay, so guys, if you have any doubt, then please do let me know on that again. Right. So you can jump to the next part of data analysis, right? Okay, Vikash is saying yes, please go ahead. Okay. Okay, so now we are going to talk about the NumPy. So what is NumPy? It's a Python library that is numerical Python. Okay. So in the numerical Python, we use for what? We use for our, we use for mathematical computations, right? So in this case, what we are going to do, we are going to use NumPy. We are going to use pandas, okay, for the data manipulation. Now, what we have done, we have our data set, right? From there, can you see we have our data, data.csv we have. If you go there, can you see we have data.csv here? So what we have in the data.csv, how I have phased the data? If you want to check the CSV file, I will show you the CSV file over here in the Excel itself. Can you see I got the title that look like the photo. Then content, I love the shoe, they are true. So I have fetched some other data. So I have fetched this data, Nike shoe one, right? If you go there, I have fetched this one, Nike women's run five running shoes, right? I have fetched this one, and then I go to the Amazon review part. Okay, from this review, I got this, right? If you click here, I got this. Now I just, if you want to go this particular, these are the reviews we have for this, right? Ratul, we mostly use Beautiful Soup. We use some predefined tools. We do use some Scrappy we use. So it's something that whatever you want to go for, there are lots of options you have. Right? So yes, this is the one, the customer review we have fetched. So this is all my data.csv all about here. So data equals to pd.read.csv. From there, content slash data.csv we have. Right? From there, if you can see, we are going to read the data, that CSV file. How to do that? That pandas that pd.read.csv. Okay? And then the path. Right? Recommendations section from the website. I never tried Niharika. Maybe we can, maybe we cannot. I just need to check that out for that. So Mohammed, we are going to do the data analysis part after this. As we have extracted the data, now we are going to do the some few data visualization, data analysis, and yeah. For Mohammed, getting the CSV file, you have to scrape the data, right? I have scraped the data from Amazon itself using this particular scraping technique. That is why I have shown you how to scrape the data. Right? In the code itself, we have this, but the data you have to scrape. Otherwise, the problem is that you will get anyway, you can use any review for that. We have unstructured data. I mean, yeah. This is a very latest data set we have. This is why this is something, it's not that much unstructured, but yeah, normally if you feel the data, it will be lots of noise will be there, right? So now if you can go and check this dot hit function is basically going to, yes, you can do this as a college project, now that's not a problem, Mohit, right? So yeah, data.hit, if you really like the video, again guys, please put the hit like button, and if you really want to update it with a new portion of the new content like this in Great Learning, then please subscribe Great Learning, right? Extension of data is, I use them .csv. If you want to use any other extension, you can use them. I mean, anyway, you will get a raw data. Okay, so after that I made them .csv. Whenever I have done the code, I have said, okay, I just need to have the data in .csv format, right? Okay, so can you see what are the columns we have? We have the columns, title, content, date, variant, image, verified, author, ratings. So title is basically what review they have given. Then content, I love the shoe, they are true to size, this date, in which date they have given that review. Then we have variant, the size, color, okay, then you have the image. If they are going to give the image for that particular one, they will show you the image verified from Amazon. Yes, it's verified from Amazon. Author, the author name in Diana Johnson. Rating is 5.0. They have given product name Nike Women's Test, and then the URL, right? The URL of the review. Okay, so this is how we have scraped the data. From there, what we are going to do, we are going to check some other parts of it. Now I am going to check the length of the data. How to do that? For checking the length of the data, you need to write length and the data. Okay, then you have to write length and the data. So the data is actually the variable name. Then if you can see the length of the data, the total columns, rows we have, that is 20, right? Then if you want to see the describe, why do we use describe? Dot describe function is a basically basic statistical understanding of your data set, right? If you want to have a basic statistical understanding for your data set, you need to write dot describe function. So in dot describe function will give you the return you that count, total count of your data, that is 20 rows you have. The mean of the data, right, 4.2. Then standard deviation 1.32. Mean is 1.0. Then you have IQR, interquartile range 25%, 50%, 75% and max. Right, so this is all about we use describe. Then comes, if you want to see how many columns you have in your data set, you just need to write data dot columns. If you just execute that, you will get title, content, date, variant, images, verified, author, rating, product, URL, all the columns we have. Okay, dot CSV file I have used, that is scraped from Amazon itself. Saddam, basically here we are trying to understand our data using data analysis part, and yes, that's the thing we are going to do over here, which is to scrape the data from Amazon and then use that data to analyze those data. I mean, what is the, you know, what are the variant that is actually there, okay? What is the content? You can do some of the NLP techniques. I mean, for this session, we are not including any NLP part, natural language processing, but you can do some of the sentiment analysis using this review, right? Okay. Now, if you want to check the shape of your data, what is the column names, what is the rows you have, so you need to use dot shape function. So data dot shape is basically, okay, data dot shape basically is gonna give you how many columns you have, how many rows you have. So I have rows 20, I have column 10, okay, this basically give you that. Now we are going to check, is there any null values is there for your columns or not? If is there, then what's the percentage of that, okay? So if you can see over here, for title we have 0% of null value, content for that we have 0, but for variant we have 0.45% of null values, and for images also we have 0.60%. I mean, not every user is going to give an image for their particular particular product. Yes, so that's not that much required as well. It's image one is like you can ignore as well if you want to do that, okay? From there, if we want to use again the like using some inbuilt function, so we have dot is in it. Dot is in it is basically giving you, is there any null value in the data set or not? So dot is in it dot any, right? Dot any means if you have any null value for the particular column or not. So for all of the cases we got false except variant images, for both we got true. I mean, there is some null values are there. Now if you want to see what is the average rating for this particular product, that time I have done this manually, that some of the data of ratings we have, the we take the column of ratings, then we take the length of the data and then divide it, the normal formula of sum, normal formula of average, right? So we got the average of 4.2. okay. Vikash, you will get the coding and the PDF differently. I mean, just register there and you will get the coding part as well and the PDF as well, right? We got lots of requests for the coding, and now we are going to give all the like live session coding and the PDF both, right? Now we are going to do the data visualizations part. So for data visualization, we are going to use two library. One is Seaborn, one is Matplotlib, right? Now we are going to change the date to date time. If you ask me why, because we our date is basically string over there. But doing the data analysis part, you have to change your date column to date time, right? To change your column date to date time, you need to use pd.toDateTime. From there, you need to write data and then your date, right? Which column you want to change. Hashmukh, we are not providing any CSV. I told you that CSV, we did not get this CSV. It's just like we fetch the data, right? We fetch the data using this scraping technique, and for after that you will make your own CSV, right? I have shown you how can you make, like, scrape the data from Amazon, then make your own CSV and do the same code. Okay, Akash, there is no option to download the PDF. I don't think so. There is an option for download the PDF. I am not sure about that. There is an option to download the PDF, if I'm not wrong. Yes, this is something you can use for what techniques are used for word and sentence embedding. So you can use some of the deep learning concepts again. Okay, so in that case, there are lots of algorithms are there in deep learning. You can use them. For sentiment analysis, you can use LSTM, you can use RNN, right? Yes. Okay. Now we are going to, as we are changing our date to 2 date time, now can you see I am going to actually take this ratings and I am changing my ratings to 2 numeric. If you ask me why, because my, again, the data, the rating we have, that is string. Now we want this rating to be in a numeric format, so that is why we have changed this numeric dot 2 numeric to x, right? Then if you can look at here, we have the distribution, right? So if you look at the distribution, so basically we are trying to check the ratings distribution, what are the most most got ratings for this particular part, right? So in that case, Rishit, I am just repeating this like every time. For all the .csv file, we have used our scraping technique and we have made that. So you use the same scraping technique we have given and you can make your own CSV file, right? You don't need to go for like using this particular CSV file. Choose any of the product and start scraping the that particular reviews from Amazon, right? It will help you to make your own product. Okay, right. Now if you can look at the ratings distribution over here, most of the people, some of them gave 2 star, like not 2, 1 point something ratings are something here, but for 4.5 is the highest rating. Can you see this 4.5 is the highest rating over here if you look at the distribution graph? Okay, yes, yeah. So this is how you can see the ratings distribution. 5 is also not 4.5, it's maybe 5 if I'm not wrong. 0, 2, 4, 6, yeah, it's a 5. Most of the people gave 5 for this one. Okay, so yes, there's a 4.5 to 5 in the range of this, the high of the highest review. That is why we got the average of 4.2. okay, right. So here, if you can go for using subplot or scatter plot to understand ratings and dates. So in that case, you can use dot scatter function, and I have given my ratings and date. If you can look at this, these are my dates and these are my ratings, right? 1.5, 2.5, 3.5, right? So these are the scatter plots are there. So if we make it as a plot, that time the plots coming is like what plot we got, right? According to the date, okay? So I have made the date and the rating, but the plot we get, this is something really, miss. But yeah, this is all the data your data is saying about, right? So if you want to change something in your data, you can do it. And you can do the further analysis as well, right? So yeah, we have almost came to the end of the session. We have scraped the data. We first scraped the data from Amazon. Then we have talked about the data analysis. We made our own CSV again. This CSV we have made, that is our own CSV. And from there, we have done the data analysis part. So if you guys have any doubt, please do. Okay, please do let me know on that. I will just give you an answer quickly and then we will wrap up today's session. Vikash is asking, one who had got an empty box would have given no star. I never tried this, Vikash. Maybe you can try this out. What's this website is gonna give you? Yes, you can do this with multiple projects. That multiple products. Yes, you can do this with any product you want to go for, right? Yes, you don't need to be like you have to use this or that. No, I mean that is why I said scrape your own data. Use that data for data analysis part. Okay, so yeah, I have shown you how can you do the scraping. Now it's up like you, which product you want to scrape and how to store the data, where to store the data. Yes, Shakshi, you can do if you want to do compare two products. We do have a, yeah, why don't you do that? I mean, just scrape this same product from two different websites and check this out, right? I hope this helps you to understand all the data. I mean, how can you do the web scraping? How can you do this, you know? I mean, you know, it's web scraping technique is something. Mohammed, thank you so much that you feel this session is a helpful one. Thank you so much. Okay, I'm really great that I can help you with that. Yes. So if you again like the video, do like the video and also subscribe Great Learning. Scraping is basically the same way we are doing the scraping, Vikash. There is nothing different from industrial projects and nothing different from you know, the app that now we are doing, right? So it's something you can do anywhere, right? So I hope I give the all the answer of your doubts, guys. If you really have any doubt, please do let us know in the comment section and do let us know what you feel about this video. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much for being with us. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. See you.